The Stoics had an interesting opinion about death. They were very accepting of it.
The wise man will live as long as he ought, not as long as he can.
Anyway, the Stoics are really interesting. But what I want to say about this fear of death and all this stuff is I kind of wonder what it is that's so scared of dying. And remember when this demon who's here now asked Jesus to send him into the herd of pigs, the pigs jumped into the ocean anyway. The pigs didn't even want to be alive with these things inside of them. So the pigs are pretty interesting. But I have a question about epigenetics. It's interesting that nobody's really talking about that in terms of the Bible, but when Jesus fed the 5,000, he made them sit down in groups. I forget if it's 5 or 10, but they had to sit down on the grass. 5,000 sitting down in groups, and then the miracle happened. In Jacob, he was able to change the goats born into spotted and speckled just by striking the sticks down by the river where they would drink and mate. That's epigenetics. And my dog was born in that way. I didn't even know it, but he was born black, looking at me with my black hair. His mother, what I'm saying, she was conceiving by the river when I was walking this rogue wild dog, and she conceived right in front of me, gave birth to black puppies. And my dog, I kept one, I whelped them, and I kept one, and he had black hair just like myself. And then I heard this Korean pastor talking about Jacob, the story where he says, he's better spotted than the speckles. And I'm like, oh my God, what is up with this miracle? It proves that the Bible is scientific, but not the kind of science that needs a lab or a lab coat. Yuck. Not the kind that needs proof besides your own. The Stoics were very much like the early Christians. Who wants to live forever? I might have lived before, but we're gonna die. We're gonna die now because I don't want any entity living, using my being to live today, because I believe the good news is to be free of that cycle.